Purple Seals.
Here's the spot.
Chose a lovely spot.
Damn it, will you relent? I'm plowing now I've done wrong.
Good. The grave's dug up and empty.
What's that mean?
Botchling's on the prowl.
Look!
Take it in your arms, quick.
And if it goes Garrity, it'll...
Keep screaming and it will turn red.
Bloody hell.
It'll bite through your... Back to the fortress.
What? With this?
As I recall, you were the one wanted to test the old legends, change it into a lubricant.
Oh, fuck. What do you want to do with it?
Me? Nothing. This is your job. Told you, gotta bury it under the threshold. If the tales are true, by tomorrow it'll be a lubricant. From then on, it'll watch over your house and help me find your family. Show me what you got. We're coming. Need to hurry.
On with it. We'll not wait till they devour us.
Thank you. chosen a name?
No.
So think of one. It's important.
It's a girl. What would Anna have named her? The world was to be your home.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
I name thee, say her name, and embrace thee as my daughter.
I name thee, Daya, and embrace thee as my daughter. What now?
In one day's time, Daya should turn into a lubberkin. I'll stay here and wait. You go home.
I'll wait with you.
Out of the question.
But that's my child. And the guilt, the responsibility for all this, lies with me.
Time for parental impulses? It's long past. Besides, nothing else you can do here.
But...
No buts. Just Witcher's work left to do here. Gotta wait a day and a night for the botchling to turn into a lubberkin. That's it. Go home, and try not to drink yourself stupid again.
By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Daya. Lead me to those bound to you by blood.
How can I help you?
What are you selling? Take care now.
Help me, Ayers.
Faster.
Fuck.
Without some lady, my arse.
go.
Whoa there, Roach. That's it, Roach.
Sure wasn't lavender they kept in there. Might be worth looking around, though. Clothing. They change in here. Horseshoe. No way a pitch burner could afford a horse. A bracelet. One of them must have dropped it. Both were here. I'm going the right way. Wants to show me something more.
Let's go! Giddy up. Faster.
Just had a field day. Still worth a closer look. Come on, come closer. Damn. Should examine that horse carcass. What do we have here? Bones have been here a while. Chewed on the saddle. Necrophages will eat anything these days. Giant claws. Wasn't a necrophage made these marks. Horseshoes missing. Is this the animal that lost one in the smokehouse? Head torn clear off. Takes incredible strength.
must have been attacked by a powerful beast. Surprised him. Hope they got away. Trail goes on. Good thing it doesn't end here. Fisherman's hut. Seems she wants me to take a closer look.
Who's that? At the room. Go on now.
What you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure, not even passing through. Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
That sir came at night, right, Mummy? Quiet, boy.
I want to help that woman. She could be in danger.
Young'un seen no one, my lord. He's a kiddie. Must have dreamt it.
I want to hear this dream then. So, kid. Who did you see? Who came here?
Pappy brought her at night, the lady does the medicines. She was all afeard. Talked about an awful monster, said she had to go back, dunno where to. Mummy and Pappy cheered her up, gave her clothes. Hers were ragged.
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough, no point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir, but you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is, hoy. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Annan, that's another tale.
Though anywhere's better than the crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I means. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
Twere like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of you. Moon had arisen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. But then I saw it. Fiery marks on her hands.
What marks?
These. Well, like burned on with hot iron. On the palms, inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. These hot and glowing, as if they burn with raw fire.
Fine. What happened next?
grew even darker. Seems someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden. And then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat. And before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'were the only reason we escaped.
The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I'd a debt. Owed Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara alerted, brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me a time of war and contempt's come. A time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman.
Crying shame we couldn't save Mrs. Anna in the end.
Thanks for your help.
The lady, she'll be all right in the end, won't she?
I'll do what I can to see that she is. So here our paths diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace.
Trusty arms for old sort.
Show me your...
Like winter.
Sent my young'uns to pick mushrooms yesterday.
To the woods? Alone?
You know how it is.
So you're that one?
What?
Got any?
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your... Farewell. I'm looking for Tamara, the Bloody Baron's daughter. Your brother said I'd find her here.
Vojtek sent you, sir.
How else would I know she was here?
Wait a moment. I'll fetch her straight away.
Looking for me, and who might you be? My father sent you.
Yeah, to see if you're still alive and well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
Got every right to be angry at your father, but he's worried about you.
I have a right. Thank you kindly. So good to have the approval of his hired thug. And my father worries only about what to get soused on next.
He's no saint, that's clear. But he's got the whole province on its feet looking for you. Finding you and your mother? Seems to me there's nothing more important to him now. I know evil men. He's not one of them.
Shame he never showed such concern before. Especially for my mother.
He made a mistake and knows that. I'm not defending him, just saying that maybe he's come to realize what he's done and what you mean to him.
Oh, wonderful. I'll bear that in mind. Did you really come all the way here just to tell me that?
Before I agreed to look for you, your father told me his version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19, and there you have my life. Finally, we'd had enough, Mum and me. He crossed the line, and we fled.
Vojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands, and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life. And that thing grabbed my mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked. Now I don't even know if she's alive.
I don't mean to pry, but I know your mother had a miscarriage.
His doing? He shoved her, she fell, that's how it started.
We were alone, no one to help, blood everywhere. Worst night of my life.
Sorry. Must have been hard for you both.
Mum was in shock. She was raving that it was better this way, that she never wanted the child. Must have had a fever. She was losing blood the whole time.
She didn't want the child?
Said she'd sooner cut open her gut than bear another child from his seed.
What will you do now?
Find my mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends. They'll help me.
What about your father?
Who? Oh, him. I don't care. I won't go back to him. That bit of my life, forgotten it already.
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
Hence the candlesticks in your room. So you believe in the Eternal Fire?
Once the heat of the fire has set your heart aflame, it gives you strength and leads you down the path of truth for the rest of your life. I hope it'll bless you with its warmth one day.
Thanks. Thing is, fire's tricky. It's easy to get burned.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good at tracking things down.
Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Gradin, witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the Bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamora, she can make her own decisions.
Noble of you. A killer for hire, abandoning his bounty for the good of another. The hunters and the Church of the Eternal Fire thank you. So the Baron hired a witcher to find his daughter. Interesting.
Desperate fathers have been known to do a lot to find their daughters.
Unexpected from a witcher. I thought your mutations cleansed you of humanity, stripped you of emotions.
You don't need mutations to strip men of their humanity. I've seen plenty of examples. Where are you gonna take her?
Tamora must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding her mother.
Hope you know what you're getting into.
I've never been more certain. The Eternal Fire is the best thing that could happen to me.
In that case, good luck.
Thank you for respecting my choice. Farewell. eternal fire walk with you.
Day gone to shit.
Taking a peek at my wares.
Yes. Yes.
Everyone to me! Well. To me!
Well, I wish you.
You'll choke to death on £3 of steel.